Mahiru Koizumi, the ultimate photographer. She had an unyielding force of personality, but she was actually very good at taking care of people. And she was always straightforward. Toward us and toward herself, she was always facing forward. She was that kind of person. Why her? Why Mahiru? Why? Why the only normal person in our group? Why did this happen to her? The muscles in my face stiffened and grew hard. Darkness clouded my vision. My legs started to wobble, and I instinctively placed my hand against the wall.
Damn it!
Hey, Hajime? Before this, we were having a great time, right? We were excited about going to the beach, we were having a lot of fun. But why?
Are you kidding me?
Why did something like this happen? Someone tell me! I obviously don't know what's going on either.
Oh!
Now's not the time to make bubbles! Hurry up and get the others! Ibuki instinctively left the beach house. I'm sure it took some time for everyone else to come here. They had to change and whatnot. It must have taken some time. But I didn't really know how much time had passed. My senses were numbed. My emotions were also numbed. Within me, various layers were peeling off. My senses started to return around the time I realized that the others were already here. Huh? What the hell is this?
Why, Mahiru!
The girls were standing outside the door leading to the beach, their faces pale with terror.
Something like this!
For heaven's sake, what in the world is going on? With their pale faces still intact, the girls began wobbling toward the beach house, until a voice stopped them.
Hold it. Those things beneath you. Be careful not to step on them.
What?
Beneath?
See? You know, the footprints in front of that door. There are footprints leading out of the beach house, right? That's probably an important clue. So don't step on them.
Huh?
If you mean evidence.
Monokuma mentioned it in the announcement, right? After a certain amount of time, we'll hold a class trial.
What the?
Another class trial?
You serious?
Then are you saying this is...
That's right!
One of you guys killed her!
Lies! Killed? That's impossible!
Hey!
It's not like an accident or something?
Lie.
If you guys think that's an accident, that still means this death was caused by someone else's actions, right?
In other words...
That also counts as a legitimate murder! Though such deaths fall into a gray area on this island, I will make sure it's clear to you guys. On this island, dying from sickness is basically the only death that's not considered a murder. Well, it's impossible to get sick and die on this island, not when Monomi takes such good care of people.
What's this?
Oh, speaking of which...
I don't like this.
There it is, the silent treatment attack. This is like the number one thing that hurts me. Well, fine. I'm not gonna lose to your bashing. I decided to become a tough kid.
This is the worst! Once again, this horrible nightmare! Another victim, and it's all because of Monokuma!
No way!
Jeez, it's not my fault! Huh? Then whose fault is it, you ask?
Yee-hoo!
To find out, we hold the class trial!
So...
Let's begin already! No whining, just begin already!
It's the Monokuma file!
This should start to feel familiar.
Do your best.
To investigate, I'll see you later at the class trial.
Class trial? Investigation? This is horrible! It's just too horrible!
Hey!
Then you should have stopped the murder before it occurred! Don't you have that kind of power?
I did have the power before he appeared.
Perhaps. Even if she tried to stop it, judging from Monokuma and Monomi's relationship, there's no doubt she'd get stopped herself.
Yes, Monokuma took everything away, including the magic stick and the surveillance cameras. The only thing I can rely on are these ears, but they can only hear about 3 times that of a normal person.
So basically...
You have no idea what's happening on this island in the first place.
I'm just the worst. A powerless rabbit like me is the worst.
Now's not the time to focus on something like that. More importantly, what should we do?
Do we have to do it again? That cruel thing? We have to do it again?
Why?
I can
not believe it. Mahiru was killed by one of us.
Damn it!
Yeah, I can't do this anymore. Investigating the class trial? Seriously, I'm done. Everyone feels the same, but we can't do anything else except do it. And there's no way we can just ignore the reason Mahiru was killed.
Hey, yeah, the only thing we can do is investigate, cause it's bad.
And that's terrible.
Cause we should never forgive that. Killing is something we should never forgive.
Chiaki.
Well, the killer has their reasons, I understand that. It was the same for Teruteru too. It's really all Monokuma's fault. I understand that too. But even so,
killing. I'll never allow it.
We should never forgive killing.
She usually has her head in the clouds, so for her to say something like that, she probably can't forgive this at all. But that's true of me too.
Understood.
Regardless, everyone is going to die if we don't do it. In order for us all to survive, we must do it.
I'm gonna do it!
Then let's do this!
Perhaps Mahiru probably wants us to do this too. She would want us to reveal the truth behind her death.
I understand. If everyone's doing it, I will do it too. But please give me a little time. Please give me time to calm myself down. Also, I will go and tell the others who aren't here about this.
You're right. If all you heard was the announcement, you won't know where the murder took place.
I shall excuse myself for now.
Hey, then let's begin. Who killed Mahiru Koizumi? Why was she killed? We gotta find out and solve this already.
That's right, we have to do it. It's the only way. I don't want to do this, but that's more the reason for us to finish this. I'm the only one who can do this. First, I need to take a look at the Monokuma file. The victim is Mahiru Koizumi. Estimated time of death is around 3 p.m. The scene of the crime where the body was discovered is inside the beach house at Chandler Beach. The cause of death is a single killing blow to the head with a blunt instrument. There are no other conspicuous external injuries and no trace of foreign substances such as drugs. Around 3 p.m., that's the time Kazuichi and I arrived at the diner. Then, if we had just gone to the beach house instead... No, now's not the time to feel regret. I need to focus on doing as much as I can right now. And then I'm going to find out the truth behind Mahiru's death. That's the only way the rest of us can survive. Monokuma file number 2 has been added to the Truth Bullet section of your handbook.
How suspicious. What is this? This is suspicious, I think.
Did you find some kind of clue?
See? You know the footprints from earlier. They were in front of the entrance facing the beach, right?
Oh, that.
Well, Hajime and Kazuichi's footprints show that you guys were the first ones to go inside the beach house. But these footprints are just the opposite. They're coming out of the beach house.
Hey.
Now that you mention it, I thought those footprints were strange too. You did? At first I tried to go into the beach house from the door facing the road. But it didn't open, so I went around and tried to go in from the beach side door. You couldn't go inside from the roadside door because Mahiru's body was blocking it, right? And that's when I noticed those footprints. The footprints leading from the beach house to the tunnel looked like they belonged to one person. Someone's footprints leading out of the beach house, huh? That's definitely suspicious.
Huh?
Now that you mention it, Peko said she went for a little swim, right? Could those footprints be...
Unfortunately, I went swimming to scout the first beach. I do not know anything about this beach.
Maybe...
Is that really true?
But still... But these footprints lead straight from the beach house to the tunnel. Since I was swimming at the beach, of course my footprints would lead from the shore to the tunnel.
Then whose footprints are these?
It appears...
It's no mistake that these are the killer's footprints, but I have no clue who that might be. Well, for now, it's obvious that this is a clue, don't you think?
Yes, it's probably an extremely important clue. Footprints on the beach has been added to the Truth Bullet section of your handbook.
I see.
I will never forgive killing.
However...
Chiaki seemed quite different from her usual self. She must feel very strongly about killing.
That... It's not just Chiaki. There is no way anyone would forgive something like this.
I guess you're right.
That's weird. What do you mean? Well, I wanted to calm myself a little, so I thought about getting a drink from that refrigerator. When I opened it a few days ago, I'm pretty sure there was a large variety of drinks.
Man.
I guess I'm just imagining things. I mean, who cares about drinks right now, huh? What are you talking about? Seriously, it's okay. I've resolved it on my own, so just drop it. What the heck? You started it. There's a lot of drinks inside the refrigerator, but compared to last time, I feel like there's less drinks. Did people take a lot of drinks from here? Not only that, the only drinks left in here look either sweetened or colored. They look unhealthy. Maybe there's a clue inside this trash can. That's what I thought, but there's only a bunch of empty plastic bottles. I don't see anything that looks like a clue. I guess it's not that easy, huh? Trash can has been added to the truth bullet section of your handbook. Mahiru. This is too weird! Something this weird should only happen in song lyrics!
Perhaps. Mahiru probably wants us to do this too. She would want us to reveal the truth behind her death. However. But what she really wanted? She probably wanted to spend time with all of us peacefully, without something like this happening.
She's lost all life in her body. It's as if she's a shell. Is this really the energetic Mahiru I knew? I see her laying in front of me, but I still can't believe it. I can't connect this lifeless body to the high-spirited Mahiru. But we don't have time to wallow in sentiment. There's no way I can just stand here. I slapped both my hands onto my cheeks and faced Mahiru's body one more time. Mahiru is leaning against the beach house door that leads to the road. If she leaned onto the door like this, it would have been impossible to open. Maybe Mahiru tried to run away when she was attacked and tried to crawl to the door. Evidence can be seen in the bloodstains on the floor. They're streaked as if she crawled through them. So she used all her energy to crawl away, leaned against the door, and took her last breath. For someone as headstrong as her to run, she must have felt really desperate. Monokuma file number 2 has been updated in your handbook. Check the truth bullet section to review it. There's bloodstains on the floor, and they're streaked as if she crawled through them. They're probably streaked from when Mahiru tried to run away during the attack. So she used all her energy to crawl away and took her last breath as she was leaning against the door. According to the Monokuma file, the fatal blow was dealt to Mahiru with a blunt object. That blunt object is this metal bat, right? Huh? This metal bat.
Yep, it's the same as in Twilight Syndrome murder case.
Huh?
Well, there's a girl named Girl E who was killed in the game during the fourth day. That girl was killed with a blow from a metal bat, just like Mahiru. Hey, did you also play that game, Hajime? Is that why you're curious about that metal bat?
Yeah, that's exactly it, but did you play it too?
Then I'm sure you know this, but the case this time is strongly connected to Twilight Syndrome murder case, I think. In order to solve the mystery behind Mahiru's death, you probably need to solve that game's mystery too.
But even if you solved the game's mystery, all the clues in it were lousy and useless. I mean, it started ambiguously and it was still ambiguous when it ended.
That's wrong. That's because you haven't beaten the game.
Beaten? I finished the game with the game over, but were you able to beat it?
I'm not some girl gamer who talks about video games she's never beaten.
So what am I supposed to do to actually beat the game? I can't stop thinking about that for some reason. But for now, I should focus on this investigation. So it's okay to say that this metal bat is absolutely the murder weapon, right? Metal bat has been added to the truth bullet section of your handbook. Hmm? What's this? Is this a mask? Did someone bring this from the toy section of the supermarket? Or maybe party goods? Regardless, why is this even here?
Could it be? Did the killer wear that to conceal their face?
No, they totally stand out. I mean, it's such a gaudy mask.
A gaudy mask? Huh? That mask!
You've seen this?
Sun Witch Esper Ito! It is a super fun anime with a viewership surpassing 90% in my country!
An anime that has a viewership of over 90%. Is Sonia's country really alright?
It cannot be! Could it be? Was that mask placed next to the body?
Yeah, it was.
If that is true, could it be? Could it be what?
I am sorry!
Please give me some time.
For reasons unknown, Sonya rushed out of the beach house. What's with her?
It appears.
It looks like she knows something. If that's the case, I shall wait until she decides to talk about it. For Sonya to be so worked up, it must be something big. I wonder what she knows. Pretty anime girl mask has been added to the truth bullet section of your handbook. The closet door is half open. The last time I came here, that wasn't the case. That's a little suspicious. I should probably investigate inside here, too. This is a pretty spacious walk-in closet, but there's so much crap on the shelves and floor only one person could stand in here. But if you think about it this way, it means it's possible for only one person to stand in here.
I've been found!
Why can't I examine the... Flotation devices, snorkels, nets, there's also some paint supplies, too. There's not much else that could be related to the incident. Wetsuits. There's a lot of stuff jammed onto the shelves, even surfboards and a surfboard case. But they're not put away properly at all. Two boards are stuffed onto one shelf, and some boards have been left out instead of being put in the case. And there's also an empty surfboard case as well. Jeez, how careless. There's something on the floor. This yellow thing, is it a gummy candy? Finding candy on the floor in a place like this, it's clearly unnatural. If it's connected to the incident, did someone drop this while they were inside the closet? Yellow gummy has been added to the truth bullet section of your handbook. I guess that's the only thing that caught my eye inside this closet. So this is the shower room. There's a notice on the door. Judging from the illustration, it looks like it's being repaired or under construction, something like that.
That's right, the shower's being repaired so water won't come out. But what about hot water? Well, that's impossible too! If the shower is out of order...
Oh, if the shower is out of order, then isn't it just a waste of space?
I'm sorry.
Just when I was planning to fix it, my magic stick was taken from me. So I never got around to fixing it.
What the heck? What does your magic stick have to do with repairing?
You're so evil!
Anyways, it's all Monokuma's fault. Everything is all Monokuma's fault. Your doubtful eyes are telling me you think I'm Monokuma's accomplice.
You must have read my mind.
Think what you want of me. I've already given up.
Got it?
But let me tell you this one more time. As long as you guys work together, you should be able to stand against any kind of despair. I promise I will help with that.
What help? You're doing the opposite. Well, anyway, it looks like the shower room is definitely out of order. But I guess I should check inside. The inside, too. Shower room has been added to the truth bullet section of your handbook. Mahiru was leaning against this door, so I couldn't open it. I guess I might as well check the inside of the shower room, too. This is a really nice, really spacious shower room. If it's this huge, you could also use it as a dressing room. But changing in the beach house is forbidden. Jeez, what an unreasonable rule. One of the monitors Monokuma uses to contact us. Nothing's on the screen right now. The only one who uses this is Monokuma. I don't think Monomi can use it. It's one of those ominous surveillance cameras. So someone must be monitoring us. There's no way they're watching us for our safety. There's a toilet, but you really can't use it as a step stool. There's a window. It's small, but maybe you can crawl out of it somehow. Well, it probably doesn't mean anything if someone can crawl through it, but I can't seem to take my mind off it. However, the ceiling is really high, so that window is also situated in a very high place. It's so high that even if I stretch out my hand, I can't reach it. It's probably about 9 feet up. And not just that, it's an iron barred window. If that's the case, yep, it'd be impossible to go in and out through there.
What?
Are you still thinking about that window? Yeah, I was thinking the killer might have escaped through there.
Leave it to me!
Alright, I got it. I'll pitch in and help you out. Huh?
Now then.
Come on, give me a piggyback ride. I'll check the window for you. Pitch in and help? It feels like I'm the one who's pitching in and helping.
I'll beat you up!
If you don't hurry up, I'll punch ya! She's really into this. No matter what I say, it's not gonna matter. Fine, I'll just leave it up to you. Don't worry, my panties are clean. I see. That's good. I let out a deep sigh, then bent over under the window.
Alright!
As she shouted, Akane jumped onto my shoulders.
Hey! Your balance sucks! Make sure your stance is wider!
You're a lot heavier than I expected.
Yeah, because I'm so buff. Like, every time I get a massage, they tell me I'm just a mass of muscles.
A massage, huh? Do you have a trainer or something since you're the ultimate gymnast?
Nah, I don't have a trainer. My stepmom's lovers like to get drunk and give me full body massages.
I shouldn't have asked.
So, how's the window?
Let's see. So that's what happened.
Did you find anything?
Well, since there's this iron bar, I was pretty sure no one would be able to get through the window. But check it out.
Check it out? Hold on. I'll give it a try.
Johnny, Youngwaj is really good here. With Akane on my shoulders, I craned my neck so high that I started to worry.
This iron bar ain't even pinned down. Looks like you can open and close it pretty easy. See? My head can fit through, no problem.
Then, it's not impossible to go in and out of that window?
Yep.
Akane jumped off my shoulders and flashed a wide grin.
Isn't this a big discovery?
But the problem is, how were they able to reach that window?
Even if I jump, I can't really reach it. But if two people worked together like us, it wouldn't be a problem, right?
If that's the case, it would mean the killer had an accomplice.
Huh?
Accomplice? Sounds like a big word. Is that the name of a kung fu master? But even if there was an accomplice, the person acting as the step stool would still be inside.
Like,
but if you really think about, just one person could get out of here without help, right? Huh? Really?
So...
yeah, like...
I got it.
A freaking ninja could do it, you know? A ninja can climb fences and walls no problem, right?
Just as I thought, it looks difficult to go in and out through that window.
Why?
What the heck? And I even took the time to lend you my wisdom!
You pissed me off.
You're the one who said it was suspicious, so I took the time to pitch in and help!
You...
it was such a waste of time to help you out. All you saw were my panties.
No, I didn't.
Oh well, it's not like it's the end of the world. I'm telling you, I didn't look at them.
Iron barred window has been added to the truth bullet section of your handbook. I guess that's pretty much everything I noticed in this shower room. I guess I finished investigating all I can. But there's still not enough. Just from the clues here, I don't think I have enough to find the truth. Looks like I should try investigating that again to find out why Mahiru got killed. Twilight Syndrome murder case. Girl E was killed in that game by a single blow from a metal bat. Metal bat. That's the same weapon that was used to kill Mahiru. There's no way that's just a coincidence, right?
Actually,
in truth, this game's theme is a missing link! You know, it's a recurring theme for mysteries, right? It's kinda like a hidden connection.
A missing link. If that's the killer's motive for the killing this time, then that mystery must be hidden inside that game. Plus, the person who might know about that mystery is standing right next to me. No, she's not. I should ask her about it. Metal Bat has been updated in your handbook. Check the truth bullet section to review it.
I took the time to lend you my wisdom.
Like I said, I didn't look at them. Seriously, please don't tell the others about that. They'll misunderstand me.
Hey, Chiaki, I have something I want to ask you. Are you okay right now?
Are you done investigating here already?
Huh? I think I finished investigating once through.
Yep. Then let's go.
Go?
So, you want to know about Twilight Syndrome, right? Then I think you should actually play it yourself. Let's go.
Yeah, you're right. With Chiaki leading, I left the beach house and headed over to Jabberwock Park where the unsettling arcade machine was placed. But I never expected that person to be waiting there.
Hello there.
Hajime and Chiaki, I'm glad you guys are doing well. Nagito? It feels like it's been a long time since I was able to talk to you two like this. Even though we haven't spoken for just a few days.
Why? Are you here?
Well,
there's no need to worry about a loser like me. More importantly, did you hear? Apparently, Mahiru got killed this time. Jeez, how horrible. She was the heart of our group, always spirited and very eager to talk. For her to be killed, if only I could have taken her place, I would have gladly done it.
Amazing!
But still, you guys will be able to shine because this outcome is full of despair, right? That's right. No matter how dark the despair, hope can shine much brighter and stronger. Though I do feel bad for Mahiru, this is quite exciting. How will everyone overcome despair this time?
Looks like he feels no remorse.
Jeez, as usual, he's acting so crazy, he's almost pissing me off. So why are you here? Who told you about Mahiru?
Now.
You don't have to make that scary face. I'll tell you, you know? Manumi.
It's Manumi! It was me!
Why do you untie Nagito without anyone's permission?
Did I do bad? I just wanted everyone to get along and, you know, cooperate.
There's no way we'll get along. You already know what kind of guy he is.
Yes, but fighting among friends is what Monokuma wants you guys to do.
Now.
Hajime, you should forgive her. Monomi is making a valid point, too. You have no right to say that.
But
now's not the time for friends to fight. There's going to be a class trial for Mahiru, right?
That's right! That's why everyone must work together and have Monokuma...
Enough! Enough already! Just go away already!
Understood!
Nagito, you too. Hurry up and get lost.
Man.
Well, I'm a little lonely, but I guess I'll do that. I already saw the true ending of that game, so there's really no reason for me to be here. True ending?
Now then.
So, although I might be a little late, I too will do some investigating for a while. I will try to be useful in my own way.
Who do you want to be useful to? The killer or us?
Isn't it obvious? I will always be on the side of hope. The more I talk to him, the creepier he gets. The more I listen to him, the more I don't understand him. If he didn't exist, this situation would be a lot easier to deal with. Damn it.
Hey, Hajime, let's just move on and start the game.
You're right. Hey, can I ask you something? Is there a walkthrough for this game?
Huh?
I feel like I'm just going to repeat the second day and fourth day again and then get a game over. So, if there is a walkthrough, can you tell me about it?
Well, when you get a game over, that's the walkthrough.
Huh? What do you mean?
Want me to tell you?
I'll tell you if you want.
There's a hidden command.
A hidden command?
See? You should have seen it too. You know, that thing that was displayed on the game over screen?
Is that... Are you talking about the message that says down 5?
That's right. Just so you know, that doesn't mean you down 5 drinks or something. It means you have to press down 5 times.
Then the hidden command is...
Yep, you just have to press the down button 5 times when you're on the title screen. If you do that, you should be able to go to the real game.
So that's the trick, just as expected of the ultimate gamer.
Nope, it doesn't have anything to do with being a gamer. This is just, you either get it or you don't. In fact, Nagito got it on his own, so it looks like he managed to beat the game. Come on, give it a try.
Yeah, I got it. I need to press down 5 times on the title screen. Alright, let's do this! Open the new door to Twilight Syndrome murder case. Please press down 5 times with your own hands. The
This is too hard. The screen changed. She was right.
Yep. This is the real game. Twilight Syndrome Murder Cases Truth Edition.
I should start it up. I need to find out why this is a motive. It'll start if I press the start button, right? Now then, let's begin Twilight Syndrome Murder Case. Please press the start button with your own hands. We open with a specific murder case, a tragic killing that occurred within the grounds of the academy that the girls attended. Based on their understanding of the crime scene, the police ruled that the incident was the work of a pervert who snuck into the school grounds. However, there was a secret behind that incident. Even before the janitor first discovered the body, there were students who witnessed the crime itself. The students were 5 high school girls. They didn't want to get involved in the incident, so they tried to hide the fact that they were the first to discover it. However, tragedy befell those girls. Several days after the incident, one of the 5 girls, Girl E, is murdered by someone. What in the world happened at this once peaceful academy? By playing the missing first day and third day, you will be able to understand that mystery. All the answers you seek are hidden in this truth edition. Will you be able to reach the truth? Now then, let's start with the first day where it all began. I'm sorry. I'm really, really sorry for keeping you all waiting. Geez, we're gonna go home late because we had to wait for Slowpoke Girl A. Come on, Girl B. You don't have to be that mad. Hey, don't go taking photos without permission. People might mistake us for good friends. I'm not your friend. What? There's no way I'd ever be friends with a nasty, trashy pig shit like you. Taha, the way Girl B treats people, even lone sharks looking to collect would get sick to their stomachs. Huh, is Girl E here yet? Apparently she forgot something. She told us to wait just a little longer. She can't find her school swimsuit. Her swimsuit, huh? Maybe it got stolen. Stolen? You don't know? A pervert has been spotted in the area recently. Kaha, you should be super careful, Girl A. A chubby weakling like you makes the perfect prey. Hey, stop it! Girl A's getting really scared. Kahahaha, it's fun to bully Girl A. Well, what was that sound? It sounded like glass breaking. It sounds like it came from the second floor. Let's go. Huff, puff, huff. Girl E, what happened? I don't know. I walked by the front of the music room just now. And then I suddenly heard the sound of glass breaking. Is someone in there? That's what I think, but I think the door is locked. I can't get it open. You're right. It's locked. Did someone lock it from the inside? Is someone really in there? If we use the key from the teacher's lounge, we can open the door, right? I'll go to the teacher's lounge and get the key to the music room. The teachers are probably gone by now, so I'm sure we can bring the key over in secret. But I have a bad feeling about this. I found the key. Nobody was there, so it was super easy to get. Then let's open it right away. Creak! Okay! Girl A, you lead the way! Huh? Mami? Come on, hurry, hurry! Thrills! Chills! Ah! Clatter, clatter, clatter. Someone's laying on the floor! She's not laying down. She's dead! Dead? That's impossible. Why? Kya! Lower your voice. They might still be nearby. Nearby? I mean, this looks like someone murdered her. Murdered, huh? Seriously, shut up. What's gonna happen if the killer notices us? Well, what should we do? What should I do?
I see, so that's what happened. I found it, the killer's escape route. Escape route? Could it be? Ah, the window is broken. The sound we heard from the entrance hall was probably the window breaking. Someone probably locked the music room door from the inside, and after killing this girl, they broke the window and escaped outside. Looks like she got hit by something when she died, but I can't seem to find anything bloody here. What happened to the weapon? Did the killer take it? So the killer just ran out the window. But if they just wanted to run away, they could have opened the window. Why did they have to break it? They were probably trying to leave in a hurry. Look, there's evidence. The fish tank by the window is tipped over and all the gravel is scattered. They must have accidentally tipped it over when they were frantically trying to get away. Broken fish tank has been added to the truth bullets section of your handbook. It's not too high to jump from the second floor, so maybe they thought it'd be safer than using the hallway. But is that really it? I mean, to lock the door, you'd have to either lock it from inside the music room or use the lounge key. Oh, when I went to get the music room key, it was in the teacher's lounge. So the killer would have had time to return the key before they broke the window. Then the door could have been locked from the inside. That means the killer was inside the music room. Also, to get outside from the music room, they'd need to have passed by us in the entrance hall. But we didn't see anyone pass by. Which means the killer's only escape route was this window. Killer's escape route has been added to the truth bullets section of your handbook. It's probably that pervert I heard about. He's the one who snuck inside the school grounds. Huh? My school swimsuit was stolen. I couldn't find it anywhere. Then the pervert who stole Girl E's school swimsuit also murdered that girl over there. They probably locked the music room so they could rape her, but she ended up resisting. So they frantically tried to get away, broke the window, and escaped. Stolen school swimsuit has been added to the truth bullets section of your handbook. Isn't it bad if we stay here much longer? I mean, I don't want to get involved in something like this, and the killer might still be around too. That's bad. Uber bad. Really? A game that's supposed to be made in the 90s would really use a word like Uber? Really? I don't think so. That's bad. Uber bad. We better hurry up and run. But don't we have to report this to the police? Don't you know what happens when you report this kind of stuff to the police? You become the prime suspect just because you found the body first. I definitely don't want that. Yeah, it'd be best if we left this room how we found it. Just lock the door, leave everything how it was. Ah, hey, please wait. Don't leave me. Girl D! Sorry, did I make you wait? So what's up? You asked me to meet here. Don't tell me you're gonna confess your love to me. Huh, what happened? I want you to look at this photo. On the day of the incident, I found this when I peeked into the next door classroom as I was going home. And I couldn't help taking a picture. What do you think this broken vase pieces mean? That sound we heard from the entrance hall wasn't the sound of a window breaking. What is this? I don't know anything about this vase. And if that's the case, the killer didn't escape from the window. So seriously, I don't know anything. It's okay, I made sure to throw it away. Huh? If anyone found it, you'd be in trouble, right, Girl E? Are you trying to blackmail me? Of course not, that's not what this is about. If there's something you're hiding from me, I want you to say it. I mean, we're friends, right? You didn't say anything, either. I knew that girl who got killed was tormenting you. Huh? No, she wasn't just tormenting you. She was seriously making your life a living hell. That bitch was in your photography club back in middle school, right? She was probably jealous of your talent, so she... I'm supposed to be your best friend. If you told me, none of this would have happened. Girl E, don't tell me you... That bitch thought she could do anything she wanted because of her family's influence. And I just couldn't stand it anymore.
You know, at first I tried to talk to her, but that bitch started talking shit about how she'd target me next time, so I felt a sudden rage, and before I knew it, I was choking her. And then she lost consciousness, but things would have been worse if she woke up, so that's why I had to do something about it. It's not my fault, or yours. It's all her fault. Ah, Girl E! That bitch, Girl E, was it? Word is she was with her on the day of the incident. Looks like she threw something away here. What was it? What the hell is this photo? This vase is. Could it be the sound of breaking glass was actually this? If it wasn't, why did she try to secretly get rid of this? That bitch, what the hell did she do to my little sister? Looks like I need to ask her a few questions. And if that bitch really did that, I will never forgive her! Looks like this is the end.
That's right. That's the Truth Edition. The incident's first day and third day are depicted in it.
Yep.
Now that you've filled in all four events from the first day to the fourth day...
Hey, Chiaki, what do you think of the characters in this game?
You mean like Girl A and Girl B? Their names make no sense and they have no romantic chemistry either.
No, not that.
See? While you were talking, looks like the ending staff roll started.
Staff roll?
Perhaps. You should be able to find out what you want to know if you look at it, probably.
What I want to know is on this staff roll. Producer, Monokuma. Director, Monokuma. Supervisor, Monokuma. Plan scenario, Monokuma. Programmer, Monokuma. Graphics, Monokuma. Sound, Monokuma. Cast, Tsumiki, Koizumi, Hyoko, not her last name Sayonji for some reason, Miyota, Sato, Kazuryu. Wait, just now-
See? Didn't I tell you? What you want to know is going to be on there.
Miracle!
Congrats! Miracle congratulations! You have finally beaten Twilight Syndrome Murder Case. Now that you guys have played this game through to the end, you should already know.
Ta-da!
That's right! This game is a non-fiction game based on an actual past incident. Is that true?
By the way,
non-fiction means an original story based on historical facts or records. Hey, answer my question. But even if this is non-fiction, you guys probably don't remember it. Well, that can't be helped. The school life you no longer remember is the setting for this story.
Our school life?
Isn't that wonderful?
At any rate, congratulations! Now then, it's for the ending prize that I'm supposed to give you as a reward for clearing the game. I won't give it to ya!
Ending prize?
There was only one ending prize and I already gave it to the first person who beat it.
Too bad!
How disappointing! Did you say ending prize?
Like, I was told the same thing when I beat it too.
Aww.
Man, I was too late. If I'd known something like this was gonna happen, I would've played the game sooner.
Ending prize has been added to the truth bullet section of your handbook. But the ending prize isn't the problem, it's what Monokuma said earlier. He mentioned how we used our school life as the setting of the game. Just as I thought, so it's connected to that this time too. But is it really true? We were already living our school lives, and our memories were completely taken. Is something that crazy actually possible? Then what did they do to us?
It looks like there's something on your mind.
Huh?
Perhaps.
Monokuma probably said the same thing to everyone else who's beaten the game. That this game is non-fiction. That is the missing link that existed in our forgotten school memories.
So do you believe it? Do you really believe our memories were taken?
I don't know, but instead of thinking about this right now, we gotta focus on solving this mystery first. Whether we believe it, it's the motive or not, it's clear that a murder did occur.
If that's the case, then I need to question them directly. If I do that, I might be able to learn something.
You're you're talking about the people whose character appears in the game, right? Then I'll go too.
That's right. If I get some information from them, I might find out about something. About the mystery behind Mahiru's death, about whether this game is true or not. And if we really had our school memories taken away.
Hey, hey, then let's hurry and ask the others. And while you're at it, ask them how it feels to be characters in the game.
Leave it to me.
Also, if you want to gather your thoughts about the content of the game, talk to me anytime.
I see, thanks. That's a huge help. I don't know where they are right now, but we won't learn anything if we just stand here. Alright, let's go.
Hello there.
Holy shit! Hello there, Hajime and Chiaki. We meet again. The timing's too perfect. You were waiting here, weren't you?
You caught me?
Wouldn't it be best if we traveled together? If you've beaten the game, we must think similarly, right?
Man.
No, maybe I'm being a little too conceited, a guy like me thinking similarly to you guys. It's okay, just make your point.
Well...
There was an airport on the first island, right? I told them to meet up there. Them?
You don't know?
Why, the characters who appeared in Twilight Syndrome murder case, of course. The girls must be busy with their investigation, too. It'd be a waste of time if we both questioned them, no?
Bye now.
If you want to hear what they have to say, you should come with me. I'll go on ahead and wait for you guys. What should we do?
I guess the only thing we can do is go.
I guess you're right. Hajime, over here! Mikan, Ibuki, Hyoko are all here. The names on the staff roll for Twilight Syndrome murder case were Tsumiki, Koizumi, Sayonji. It was actually Hyoko, but whatever. Miyoda, Sato, Kizuryu.
Wow.
I really wanted Fuyuhiko to come too, but he locked himself in his cottage and wouldn't come out for me.
Sorry.
Unfortunately, he's absent. It's probably because I'm so incompetent. I apologize.
What?
It's okay to be absent? I thought you said we'd get executed if we didn't come.
Executed?
Because, I mean, you had said Mayukuma had something important to tell us, right? We came because you told us that.
Sorry, that was a lie.
A lie?
You tricked us?
What the?
Jeez! Fine, then I'm leaving.
Wait!
Can you wait until we finished our business with you, right, Hajime? This is like I'm on the same team as Nagito. No, I can't focus on that right now. I have to get information from them. The names on the staff roll.
Oh, jeez.
Not fair!
I can't believe you actually tricked us so we'd come to this place. I have nothing to say to impudent, regular people like you.
Regular, huh? She's right that I might be a regular guy, but I also have an ultimate talent, or at least I should have one. Hey, Buki, can I ask you something?
Why, you?
Bring it on! Have you played Twilight Syndrome Murder Case?
Aww.
Well, that's a computer game, right? I'm basically awful at those things.
Guitar!
Hey, Buki's a tough girl, so I don't touch anything powered by electricity except electric guitars. I'm pretty sure that's a lie, but now it's not the time to really dwell on something like that. Her unique tone and hyper-energy, there was a character like that in the game too. Let me ask you one more thing. What's the relationship between you and Mahiru?
You mean that in a perverted way?
No, in a normal way.
Aww.
Well, even if you ask me that, if Fuki's encounter with Mahiru was...
Oh! When I asked Mahiru this morning to go to the beach with us, she made this really disappointing face.
A disappointing face?
I see.
Yeah,
I see.
But disappointment varies depending on the person. Ibuki associates it with department store rooftops.
Let's stay focused on Mahiru.
That's totally it!
It turns out, Mahiru had some business too, and she wanted to invite me to that island. She said something like, I was thinking about meeting with everyone, but if you already have plans...
Do you know what she meant by everyone?
Aww.
Nope, I didn't ask. I see. Mahiru invited Ibuki. Why? Hey, do you have a minute? There's something I wanted to ask you. Have you played Twilight Syndrome Murder Case, Mikan?
Nope. Since we said we weren't going to play that game. Also, I'm not really good at video games. I'm pretty slow, and I panic instantly.
Her timid tone. I'm pretty sure the Girl A character was like that, too.
Hey, hey. Anyway, can you tell me about your relationship with Mahiru?
I mean, Smiki was just playing a video game yesterday morning with, Chiaki. But, you know.
Relationship with Mahiru?
Well,
I first met her, when we first gathered at the classroom with everyone else. And after arriving at the island, I did have a few conversations with her, but... Could it be? Did Mahiru hate me? That's definitely it. She hated me.
She doesn't know anything. No, it's more like she doesn't remember anything. But...
But even though she hated me, for her to actually invite me, she must have been a really kind person.
Hmm? Invite?
Mahiru invited me this morning.
This morning?
She looked very serious, and she was wondering if we could all meet up so she could discuss something. But I already had plans to go to the beach, so I had to decline because I needed to prepare for that. And when I did, she made this lonely face and said that she'd reschedule for another day. But if only I went with her, this wouldn't have happened.
Mahiru invited Mikan. Why?
I see.
Looks like we've obtained some pretty valuable testimonies based on that. It seems like Mahiru also beat that game. Why? Why do you know that?
You don't know?
If she hadn't, she wouldn't have chosen these people to talk to. Because she beat the game, she talked to the people who appeared in that game. Just like what we're doing right now.
But still, in her case, it was much more serious, probably. I mean, she was forced to learn that she was involved in that game.
That's true.
But I'm surprised. I never thought Mahiru would play that game.
It's true. That was unexpected. Nagito, didn't you tempt her into playing that game?
Huh?
What? I remember. Anyway, what happened to Mahiru? Did she leave saying she had some business to take care of? Huh? Why do you know that? Wait, you tempted her, right? Just like you did to me.
Mean.
Tempt? That's a rude thing to say.
No, that's wrong!
That's disrespectful toward Mahiru.
Isn't that right?
There's no way her feelings would change just because a useless guy like me tempted her. At that time, she was already considering giving that game a try. All I did was give her a little push.
It's obvious.
That's all it was. What the heck?
Well...
More importantly, isn't it better if we listen to what she has to say? She's being quiet as ever. I'm counting on you, Hyoko.
Hey.
If Mahiru spoke to everyone who appeared in the game, she should have talked to you too, right? Well, Hyoko?
She never talked to me at all.
That's weird. What a surprise. I didn't expect you to ask me such an easy question.
Bye.
So, I'm just gonna go back to my cottage now.
Hey, Hyoko. Ignoring my voice, Hyoko ran away as though she were avoiding me. Looks like it's okay to say she ran away. Yeah, she's clearly suspicious. That's pretty much decided. Decided?
Now then.
Regardless, it looks like we're finished here, so why don't we part ways for now? There is still something I need to investigate.
Bye now.
I'll see you again later. Hey! What the heck is his problem? Even his exit was pushy. Chiaki, what should we do? Should we go back to the scene of the crime one more time and investigate?
It's very important to investigate the scene of the crime, but let's go over to Mahiru's cottage first.
Mahiru's cottage?
If she beat that game, it's best if we investigate there, I think.
See?
She might have that.
Oh, the ending prize. If that's the case, I'll go with you. You're okay with that, right? That's your cue to say yes. Oh, why does this go so fast?
see?
Mahiru's cottage. It should be on this side in the very back.
The door looks unlocked.
Moving after you're told would be too third-rate, so I made sure to be one step ahead. However, removing what's inside is a huge no-no. There are others you want to investigate, too.
I guess I should go inside. Compared to my room, the cottage had a somewhat pleasant smell wafting through the room. That proves Mahiru was here. But she's not coming back.
Then I should... try looking for a naughty book.
Why?
Yep.
Now, I was only kidding.
Kidding? Are you that kind of person? Geez, well at least I don't feel nervous anymore. Wait, could that be the reason she said that?
See? But it looks like we don't need to search for it. Check out that thing on top of the bed.
On top of the bed? No. If you miss this one, you miss it.
No.
Just like my cottage, it has an open design that evokes a feeling of tropical relaxation. There's not much that catches my eye. These photos, Mahiru must have taken them. She probably developed them at the supermarket. Even in this situation, there's a lot of photos of smiling people. Is that because of her personality? There's a shower room past this point. Even though I'm investigating, it feels awkward to go in there. Looks like there's no clues either. There's an envelope on top of the bed.
Hey, could it be? This might be it. The ending prize Monokuma gave to the first person to beat the game. What's inside the envelope?
Let's find out. I turned over the envelope and what came falling out was... a few photos.
This photo!
This is... a photo of Mikan, Ibuki, and Yoko in what appears to be some sort of entrance hall. It's just like that game.
Yep. There is a similar scenario during the first day in Twilight's Truth Edition. Girl B was in a bad mood because Girl A was late, and Girl D tried to cheer her up by taking her picture.
This is, it's weird how, Ibuki's, outfit is exactly the same as in DR3, but the other two aren't. Is this the photo she took? Entrance hall photo has been added to the Truth Bullets section of your handbook.
Look at this photo, too!
A broken vase?
Is that the same photo Girl D showed Girl E on the third day?
As I recall, a broken vase was in the classroom next to the music room. Broken vase photo has been added to the Truth Bullet section of your handbook.
But still, this photo is more shocking.
As Chiaki showed that photo to me, I was stunned into silence.
This is an actual photo of a dead body. Since there's a piano behind the body, it looks like it's in the music room. If that's the case, could this be the photo of the first victim?
You mean, it's the victim of the murder that occurred on the first day?
Oh. Yeah, the one they blamed on a pervert.
High school girl's crime scene photo has been added to the Truth Bullets section of your handbook.
And one more. This is the last photo. This is probably the photo of Girl E after she got killed on the fourth day. It nearly matches her body in the game. See? Yeah, there's no mistake. This is a photo of Girl E.
Girl E's crime scene photo has been added to the Truth Bullets section of your handbook.
With that, we finished looking at all the photos.
So based on all these photos...
Yep. Yeah, seems pretty clear. This is the ending prize.
This is the ending prize for beating Twilight. And what's depicted in these photos? Proofs that Twilight Syndrome murder case is based on an actual murder. Does that mean that stuff about our memories being stolen?
What's this?
Is there something else?
See? There's a note inside the envelope.
Try playing Twilight Syndrome. After you get a game over, press down 5 times for the real game. Once you do, you should remember what you all did to my sister. We'll talk then. This note...
Wait. Time out. Maybe the first person to beat the game and receive the ending prize wasn't Mahiru.
Someone else sent this to Mahiru. And that person is the one who actually received the ending prize. Mahiru wasn't just lured there by Nagito, she also received this envelope.
Yep, and that's why she played that game, right?
Then the person who played this game first... This envelope looks very familiar. And the word sister written in this note. Based on these clues, I can't think of anyone other than him. Ending prize has been updated in your handbook. Check the truth bullets section to review it.
Hey. I'm glad we came here to investigate. Because we did that, we discovered a very important clue.
Yeah, I agree. But there's still one thing left. We have to find out who actually killed Mahiru, but there's not much time left. I need to hurry. Hajime and Chiaki, what a coincidence. If something happens twice, third time's the charm, so they say. What coincidence? Are you a stalker or something?
Now.
Don't say that. I was just thinking about filling you in on the results of my investigation. Results. Did you find something?
Bow to me.
I'll let you know if you drop to your knees and lick my shoes. Huh? Just kidding. I was joking. It didn't sound like a joke to me.
Actually...
Well, it's about the footprints. The killer left their footprints in front of the beach house, right? Did you find out whose footprints those are? If you want to know, I highly recommend you come to the beach house with me. With you? Of course, you'll come with me, right? I don't trust him as far as I can throw him, but if I can get a clue... What are you going to do, Chiaki?
I'm going to try to talk to Fuyuhiko and see if he can tell me anything. So, I'll leave this to you.
Yep.
That's definitely a good idea. If someone like me tried to talk to him, it'd be impossible, but it might be different with a girl. Just be careful that he doesn't get rough with you.
Yep, I guess this is where we part. I'll see you later, Hajime.
What?
Did you actually want her to stay? Actually, what do you mean?
Bye now.
Let's go. I'll go on ahead to the beach house and wait there. I was right. Huh?
What happened?
I already
Sarah?
Assumed you would come here.
Fine.
There is nothing you can do. You can hide from me, the supreme overlord who wields the 4 dark devas of destruction. Thus I know everything. For instance, I happen to know you fiends.
I can see it!
We're preoccupied with your infantile beach play.
Nature, the collective will of the world.
It matters not, for what I love is silence and solitude. That's right. That's it. That's precisely it.
I see. So he wanted to be invited too. No.
Now then,
let's try going inside. My, Nagito?
Whoa! Why the hell are you here?
Hello there.
Kazuichi, thanks for going easy on me earlier. Thanks to you, I was able to walk away with just mild bruising. You clearly think like an ultimate.
What the heck?
This bastard.
You two have arrived at a good time.
Good news!
I have discovered something very terrible!
A terrible discovery?
Not only that, I believe it's nothing like Sonya's, but there's something I noticed too.
You too, Mikan? Yep, this is great. It looks like the investigation is reaching its boiling point. Hey, tell me what you know already. Didn't you find out whose footprints those were? Actually, how were you able to find that out? After listening to everyone's story at the airport, I went to a certain place. Well, it's probably better to say I snuck in. To everyone's cottages. Everyone's cottages?
Yep.
I told Monokuma I needed access for the investigation, so he simply let me in. That bastard, he did something shady again.
Now then.
But why did I do something like that? Well, I'll explain my reasoning to you. Nagito squatted down near the entrance to the beach house and began to spread some papers he was holding.
See?
Come on, Hajime, take a look. After all, I went to the trouble of gathering all this. These footprints. I see, so the reason you snuck inside everyone's cottages was...
Yep.
That's right, I wanted to get a sample of everybody's footprints. But unfortunately, Fuyuhiko wouldn't leave his cottage, so I couldn't complete it. Well, I guess it's no big deal. It seems obvious that the footprints belong to this person. Whose footprints are they?
Yep.
Hyoko Sayonji. Hyoko's?
Well...
To be honest, the reason I summoned her to the airport was so I could lure her out of her cottage. She shut herself inside her cottage, remember? If she stayed in there, I couldn't sneak in.
Perhaps?
So I figured if I lured her out, she wouldn't be in a hurry to go back to her cottage. You're treating her like a small animal. But it was totally worth it. The footprints I collected there were smaller than anyone else's and matched the footprints at the beach house. Huh, that's actually consistent with his handwriting from the first chapter. Yep, there's no mistake. These are Hiyoko's footprints. Footprints on the beach has been added, updated in your handbook. Check the truth bullet section to review it. Stepping on the beach, Also, it's not like I was snooping around or anything, but I found something really interesting at her cottage. Something interesting?
See?
I found a lot of these candies inside her room. That's... They're gummy candies that come in four different flavors. Strawberry, melon, grape, and orange. It looks like she got it from the supermarket. Apparently, she really likes this brand of gummies. There should have been other gummy brands, but she only brought home a bunch of these. People are like that sometimes. There are people who only eat the same brand, even if it's just potato chips. What's wrong with that? Why is he getting so defensive? Well, it's not clear if this relates to the incident, but I thought I should tell you just in case. Just in case. Coming from this guy, that means it probably greatly relates to the incident. Gummy bag has been added to the truth bullet section of your handbook.
Oh my!
Miss Sonya, she looks strangely excited.
Whoa! Awesome! That's like a powerful Gatmo, eh?
Man, I don't really get it, but nice one, Princess, that Miss Sonya is something else. This guy is just so laid back, I should leave him alone.
It appears...
We're nearly out of investigation time.
Now that you mention...
Mikan just finished performing the autopsy. She might have found an important clue, don't you think? Also, it seems Sonya has some information, too.
I apologize.
I am not being that helpful.
Big news!
Huge, huge news!
What's the big news?
See? Remember that Sun Witch Esper Ito mask that was next to Mahiru's body?
Oh, the mask the killer used to hide their face.
Listen! No, that is not correct! That mask was not just used to hide their face!
Then what was it for?
Well, Sparkling Justice.
Huh?
Sparkling Justice is a serial killer and self-professed ally of justice whose name makes mankind shudder. They wear a hero mask at all times. Supposedly, they are a serial killer who only murders other criminals.
That is an order!
Do not look so disappointed, Hajime. You need to be surprised.
Hey,
This sparkling justice character, that's the serial killer you were talking about before, right? It's true that the mask we found is a hero mask, but...
Wow!
It is a heroine mask, to be precise! Sun Witch Esper Ito is a pretty witch girl! See? A heroine!
Anyway...
So you're saying it's possible that the serial killer is the one who killed Mahiru? Which means there's a serial killer hiding among us. I'm pretty sure I've seen a twist like this in some video game. This is stupid. Serial killer my ass. The killer just used it to cover their face.
That's weird.
But even so, they sure chose something that stands out. That might be true, but...
However...
Although it's easy to write this off as foolish, it might be best if we exercise some caution. Sonia, can you tell me everything you know about this so-called sparkling justice?
As the light of justice shines upon my mask, I expose the hearts of malevolent evil!
The hell?
Justice complete! The center of justice that is pierced by justice! The lead star of justice that shines in the night sky! That would be me! Sparkling justice!
What the heck was that?
Well, that is Sparkling Justice's catchphrase!
What?
An unknown serial killer has a catchphrase?
Do you have a minute?
I read it in a magazine in the library. There has only ever been one person, a journalist, who has interviewed Sparkling Justice. The article was written in their native language, so I tried translating it.
However,
in the end, that journalist was punished by Sparkling Justice too.
No good can come from getting involved with a serial killer. The serial killer might not want to hear that from you.
This is all I know about Sparkling Justice. Thanks to the masks, nobody knows their true age or gender, making them a very mysterious individual.
Hey, isn't that kind of a stretch to say that there's a serial killer hiding in our group?
Listen!
No, it does not mean they are in our group.
It is possible the serial killer was lurking on this island all along before they decided to murder Mahiru.
Well...
That's probably not possible.
But that is the only thing I can think of. I mean, no matter how much time I think about it, I simply cannot believe it. That one of us is capable of committing such a horrible murder. No matter how much I think about it, I simply cannot believe it.
Sonia. I do understand Sonia's feelings, but it's highly unlikely that there's a serial killer hiding on this island. Mikan, you had something to say too, right?
Well, compared to the others, what I have to say isn't that important. So please don't get your hopes up and be disappointed.
I get it, so just get on with it.
I tried my best to perform the autopsy, and I was able to find out Mahiru was definitely killed by a blow to the head. She was probably struck from behind by one blow. Based on the scar, the weapon is clearly the metal bat. But every dark cloud has a silver lining, as they say. It looks like Mahiru didn't suffer.
What does that mean?
Well, there's no doubt that she died instantly.
Her death was instant? That sounds a little strange. I think I'd better remember that. Nikon's autopsy report has been added to the truth bullet section of your handbook.
And there's another thing I found. I'm sorry I started talking on my own. Are you busy right now?
Just tell me.
Well, during the autopsy, I discovered this in Mahiru's pocket.
I was going to tell you in person, but I couldn't find you, so I put this in your mailbox. About what we discussed earlier, is it okay if we change the place and time? I want you to come to the beach house on the second island at 2:30 p.m. It seems there's someone who wants to interfere with our meeting. Let's keep it a secret. Until then, let's try not to see each other for a while. It would be bad if they started suspecting us for no reason. Hayoko Sayonji. This letter.
If this letter is real, it would mean Hayoko met up with Mahiru, right? Plus, Mahiru's estimated time of death was around 3 o'clock p.m. and...
Oh wait, that's Hinata. Plus, Mahiru's estimated time of death was around 3 o'clock p.m. and they met 30 minutes prior.
If we think about what that implies, then... I'm starting to get confused!
If it's true, what does it mean? What happened between Mahiru and Hayoko? Letter on Mahiru has been added to the truth bullet section of your handbook. Ding dong, ding dong.
mechanism has come to an end! Come! Now is the time to fight the decisive battle! The hostility of fresh blood, the insanity of a contest of wits! The class trial is finally raising its curtain! So meet up in front of Monokuma Rock! Once you're there, please proceed to the underground by taking the elevator located at the secret entrance. I'll see you soon!
Now then.
Looks like it's time. I guess the investigation is over. So it's finally starting, the class trial where our hopes and the killer's hope will finally clash. But it's all right. Either way, hope will win in the end.
All right!
Now then, let's go prove it. What's he so excited about? There's no reason to respond to a guy like that. Anyway, we should start heading over. At the trial field where Monokuma is waiting, I have to make my case there.
There is no escape.
We have no choice but to press forward. Now then, let us go. As we talked among ourselves, we left the beach house and Mahiru's body.
This way.
What, you stubborn little Lolita?
Everything about that exchange was disgusting.
Stop harassing little girls!
This is what's going on.
Sheesh. Hiyoko was trying to run away, so Monokuma brought her here by force. But Hiyoko's still trying to run away, so Monokuma's trying to wrap her into a full Nelson.
Damn it! If you don't stay put, I'm gonna make you a part of this island's food chain!
Unbelievable.
Jeez, making me waste my sweet-ass time. There's another problem to deal with besides this one. Where the heck is Fuyuhiko? That guy, he totally ditched my appointment. He pisses me off.
His anger changed his form. I'm right here.
Hmm?
Ah, Fuyuhiko, you came. I was worried about you.
There's nowhere for me to run anyway, so no matter the ending, I have to accept it, right? But still...
Bastard!
I'm a Yakuza. Accepting defeat is not an option. Fuyuhiko, what does that mean?
Well, it's all good. If the trial heats up, it's all good.
Anyway...
Looks like everyone's here, so let us depart now.
See ya later!
I'll go first and be one step ahead of you guys.
This is bad.
Crap. I'm not mentally prepared yet.
Like,
do you even have to prepare?
Show some spirit!
If you don't have enough power, harness your latent energy. Come on, bring out that energy!
This, too, must be the will of causality.
So it begins. The beginning of the end.
Now then, let's keep our spirits high, so we can one day find that shining hope. That's right, I can only... Moving forward is the only option. I'm a Yakuza. I won't run or hide.
Mahiru? Why did Mahiru... This isn't possible!
Damn it!
I'm not mentally prepared yet. Like, I don't even think I'll ever be. But we can't just stand around all day. Yeah, I guess you're right.
What the?
Monokuma changed forms! Color me surprised!
Hey, hey!
Could he be the type to awaken hidden powers when he gets angry? He's a stuffed animal, right?
If you don't unleash your power here, where else are you going to unleash it? Don't you want to avenge Mahiru's death?
This class trial stuff again, so this time we gotta figure out who killed Mahiru, huh? I don't get complicated stuff, so I'll leave this to you guys.
Cause it's bad.
It sure is bad.
Let's go. We can't forgive the killer. Listen! The truth behind Mahiru's death. Sparkling justice may hold the key. No, that just has to be it.
Then...
let's go. There's no reason for us to waste time here. What are you dilly-dallying for? Come on, let's hurry up and go. Dilly-dallying.
I have nothing to do with this. I believe in you. If everyone works together, you should be able to stand against any despair.
Alrighty!
I will definitely help you out.
You should be honored.
It's nearly showtime!
A mere human such as yourself will be present to witness the beginning of the end.
What if one day it just, like, collapses on someone?
Evil. No matter how many times I see it, it's such bad taste. The worst, the lowest, most brutal taste.
Somehow, I moved my muscles stiff from fear and nerves and awkwardly walked onto the escalator. For some reason, my breathing was short and I was eventually struck by a feeling similar to dizziness. The moment all of us were inside Monokuma Rock... a rumbling sound filled the room and the surrounding space began to fall. As it shook with a clatter, the elevator we were inside continued to drop. Throughout that drop, I was fluctuating between feeling hope and despair. As if my heart was a rotten fruit swelling in the sun before it finally goes, squish! I suddenly stopped breathing. Look at Pekko and her little braid pigtails. My consciousness began to fade from the pressure. I tried to endure that pressure by firmly standing on my legs. And after a while, the elevator's vibrations gradually weakened. And then it stopped altogether.
Ta-da!
Aim! Defeat the boring routine!
So?
I've decided to start redecorating. How does it look? Mr. Monokuma's redecoration is awesome, isn't it?
Impossible!
It's not like I'd allow you to think otherwise, anyway.
That is, to go to the trouble of doing something this elaborate, really... what is your true intention?
No!
Nothing really. Essentially, this killing game is just to kill time anyway.
You kill time?
Yeah!
To break away from my purpose! That alone is my purpose!
Like...
a purpose is only gonna be a weakness. Those who have purpose are always the weakest ones in the bunch. That's why you guys should forget about such cheap-ass purposes like trying to survive! And enjoy the class trial from the bottom of your hearts!
It's starting. The class trial is starting. Mahiru Koizumi, the ultimate photographer. She had an unyielding force of personality, but she was actually very good at taking care of people. Most importantly, she was always straightforward. The person that killed her... is among us? I don't want to believe it. I don't want to believe it. I don't want to believe it, but... regardless, we need to find the answer. It doesn't matter if you believe it or not. Because it's the only way. Aside from finding out who the killer is, there is no other way for us to survive. And so, this life-threatening trial billowing with hope and despair has begun.